Distinguished colleagues, dear participants, at the outset I would like to extend our appreciation to the permanent missions of Canada, Finland, Hungary, Japan, Kenya, the Netherlands, Portugal, Singapore and Tajikistan to the United Nations, as well to the UNDESA and UN Water for organization of today's important high-level event. Indeed, fresh water, food and environment, as well sanitation and hygiene, are essential to address and to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Meeting the water needs of a growing population, contributing to public health in the wake of the COVID-19 sanitary crisis, dealing with water-intensive consumption patterns and water pollution, are key factors undermining the achievements of poverty eradication and sustainable development. Water is a powerful tool for cooperation and dialogue in support of sustainable development and safer societies. However, there is a need for more efficient, integrated and coordinated actions coupled with stronger political will. All stakeholders must be engaged actively, paying special attention to the livelihoods of poor and vulnerable people, leaving no one behind. Equally important are forward thinking and a strong will to promote innovative approaches to local, national, regional and international water cooperation in the aftermath of the COVID-19 sanitary crisis. Dear participants, we believe that open discussions of the issues shaping our water resources, like today's event, can stimulate cooperative and transformative solutions and actions. The government of Tajikistan, as a part of its international commitments and contributions, will continue providing a platform for policy dialogue, partnership and action, and organizing with the support of the United Nations and other partners high-level international conferences throughout the Water Action Decade, thus promoting Dushanbe water process. Unfortunately, due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the organizing committee of a second high-level international conference on the International Decade for Action Water for Sustainable Development 2018-2028 decided to postpone it to later dates. Availing this opportunity, I would like to inform that long-term observations of our experts testified to the increasing impact of climate change on the environment, social and economic situation in Tajikistan and Central Asia. Day after day, the negative impact of climate change on the quality and quantity of fresh water resources is becoming increasingly evident. In Tajikistan, over the past decades, there has been recorded a significant reduction of the glaciers, which are vital for the entire Central Asia. Recognizing water resources as the main component of sustainable development, we are concerned with the changes in hydrological cycles that adversely affect water, energy and food security and can lead to additional risk of floods and severe droughts. The countries of our region have to revise their program and strategies for water use, especially in agriculture, and take joint measures to promote sustainable development and adaptation to climate change. This year, Tajikistan has started chairing the International Fund for Saving the Aral Sea. During our chairmanship, we will continue efforts in strengthening dialogue and cooperation to address water problems related to climate change as well as reforming the fund. In conclusion, I would like to underline that progress is possible when countries and regions commit to prioritizing the water, sanitation and climate challenges. This is particularly true in the case of water shared among different sectors, as well as surface and groundwater shared among communities and countries. Integrated approaches and concerted actions at all levels are long-term and complex process which can only happen with strong leadership and alignment on the overall objectives. Thank you for your attention.